Hey, how you going? I'm just making a quick video on how to handle and go about picking up and handling and dealing with aggressive snakes. I know when I first started out trying to figure out and trying to watch movies and videos on how to go about it, I struggled to find a couple of decent videos on YouTube that kind of helped me out a lot. So I'm going to be talking about that. I've got two different examples of snakes. I've got a really placid coastal jag that I'll be showing you, and I've got a bit more of a fiery jungle jag girl, and she's pretty crazy at the best of times. First thing I could say is, if you've got it in a click-clack container and your snake is quite aggressive, every time you open that container up and come in over the top, the snake's probably thinking you're a giant predator because they live on the ground and the rest of it. I've found what works for me is something similar to one of these enclosures with, you know, a door that slides at the side so you can see into the snake can see out, and you're kind of all of a sudden on the same kind of level rather than just hovering over the top. I found that to help temper it quite a bit, especially with even new snakes that you get. They might try and rip your head off. All of a sudden, once they settle into one of these, they tend to calm down a lot more. So we're just going to get straight into it. I'm going to get out the female coastal jag first, and we'll see how she's going. So she's generally, at the worst of times, very placid. As you can see, I haven't had a drama there getting her out. She isn't aggressive whatsoever. She's the kind of snake that you could leave with your children if you have any children. Like, she's very the opposite to aggression. Even when I first got her, I didn't have really an issue with her. I don't think she's ever struck at me once. She feeds like a champion and she smashes her food, but she's never ever shown me any signs of aggression. And even just watching the nature of her, like, see when I've got her out straight away, she's not trying to wrap my hands together or not really tightening around my hand. She's quite chilled out, she's happy to be stretched out. Even if I leave her on one hand, like, she's pretty relaxed. She's just looking for a place to chill, and I guess she's kind of shocked because I've probably just woken her up. So that's the first example. Now, that's easy to get out a calm snake, but a more aggressive snake can be a lot more intimidating to a lot of people. So let's go and have a look at that. So this next one is the jungle jag female. She's about 16, 17 months old. As you can see in there, I don't know if you can see, she's fired up anyway. She's a real piece of work, and it's nothing. When I first got her, I would probably get bitten at least 10 to 15 times when I would go to hold her. Now, she's calmed down quite a lot. There's a really good chance I'll get struck. First thing when you go in to pick up a snake, regardless of what type of enclosure you're keeping it in, you don't want to get halfway or touch it and let it turn around and try and go to you and then back off, because all of a sudden the snake, number one, thinks it's got fear into you, which is quite common, and straight away you're stirring it up even more, like going halfway. It's like someone that keeps on poking you or tormenting you. Like, if you're going to go to pick it up and it's angry, just go in and pick it up anyway. If it bites you, bad luck, you're being bitten. If it doesn't bite you, then that's a win because you haven't been bitten. And a snake this size realistically isn't going to cause much damage. I don't know if you can see in my hand just from earlier tonight, there's a couple of tiny little spots there, and that was from this exact snake when I went to clean her out. It's really nothing, and she rarely draws blood, so let's just see how she goes. And try and take notice of the temperament as well. So she's probably, yeah, there you go. So she's quite angry. She doesn't want to come out at all. Okay, so you saw her strike maybe three times then. She got me once, and I don't even think you can see it on the top of my hand there. But see, she's stressing a lot more in the language of the snake. Now, what you want to try and do is keep her stretched out as much as you can. See how she's, every time she gets a chance, like if I leave her on one hand, there's a good chance that she's gonna try and wrap it just like this, and try and, if I start moving my other hand around, she's gonna try and get ready to take me out. Now, for starters, a snake this size, honestly, that's a bite from it. It really doesn't hurt anyway. Like, I could let her bite me all day, and she's not gonna hurt, and she looks like she's being a good girl now. But what you wanna do is, when you've got a snake like this in your hands and you're trying to tame it, see if you can, as much as you can, don't stretch it right out, but just hold it comfortably between two hands so she can't coil around one hand and use it as leverage to try and whack you off of. The best thing you can do is try and keep it stretched out between two hands and let her just crawl between them, and then just like this, you know, go for up on the head and slide your other hand down, and straight away she knows that these big objects that are our hands are coming towards her, not to cause her harm, but you know, it's more so that she's in a safety net when she's in, and we're not gonna try and inflict damage. This snake still has a long way to go. She's got a real attitude, but she's come so far. Like I said earlier, I think she used to bite me between maybe 10 or 15 times when I go to pick her up. But the best thing, a bigger snake, obviously you have to take more precaution because they can inflict a lot more damage, such as even hooking, using hooks, hooking a snake out, handling it by the tail even, if you need to. But as much as you can, I'd recommend going with your hands at a snake this age, so it just knows that when the hands come in, it might get you once or twice, but it really knows you're not there to cause it damage. You're gonna get it out and keep it safe. I hope this video has been helpful. I haven't really used many scientific terms or gone into anything really deep because I know it's a lot easier to siphon through information that's easy to understand. Pardon me. So yeah, I guess it's a couple of simple little tips that have worked for me, and hopefully they'll work for you too. Thanks for watching.